Hi everyone, my name is Jing. Welcome to my art channel, Brush Impact. Today I will talk about how to understand and master the fill tool in Clip Studio Paint. We'll discuss the subtool and tool properties labeled here. These are great tools used to facilitate creation of quick silhouette or doing color flats, especially when there are multiple layers involved in a document or if the line art is not that perfect. About the artwork. I did this piece for the upcoming spooky season. So to get into that vibe, I drew this magical bell tower here. We'll be using the line art of the ghost hand to demo fill tool techniques. I've created my flats layer just right below my line art layer. The fill tool can be generally found here. The icon looks just like a paint bucket. You can easily hotkey it by pressing the letter G. What we'll look out for next are the subtool and tool property windows. If for some reason you're not able to find the subtool and tool property, you can always go to the window menu and you should be able to find the subtool and tool property. Refer to all layers. I'll make sure to select refer to other layers first, and then go right ahead and fill in my line art here with a bluish color. Now, what just happened here is that the entire canvas became blue, which is not the goal. The reason is that the refer to multiple box is unchecked. If I go ahead and click on the refer multiple box, you'll see that I have different options. All layers, reference layer, selected layers, and layer and folder. Once I select all layers enabled and try to fill in my drawing, you'll see that it effectively fills inside the line art since Clip Studio Paint sees all the layers in the document while the fill tool is active, and whichever layer is seen, the fill tool will refer to that and take it into consideration. So the reason why the fill tool actually stopped where the bell tower is because it could still see it. Once I hide the bell tower, what happens is the fill tool will continue to fill the line art. Refer to reference layer. This is actually great for filling in a specific part of the line art, or in this case, a text layer, given that it is in a separate layer. This solution is very ideal, especially if there are numerous layers in your document, and it'll help the fill tool isolate what exactly needs to be filled in. Let's say I want Clip Studio Paint to only see this magical bell tower text. In order for that to happen, I will have to set it to be my reference layer by clicking this lighthouse icon here, which says Set as Reference Layer. Or I can right-click on the layer thumbnail itself to do that. Clip Studio will now treat this layer as the only layer to be referred to. So, if you fill the outside of the text, the background gets colored. Unfortunately, there are color leftovers here, and it would be quite painstaking for me to individually fill those in. Another trick is that if you uncheck Apply Connected Pixels Only, what this does is that Clip Studio Paint fills in similar colors, whether they are next to each other or not, such as the areas in between the letters. If I click inside the text layer, it only fills the text itself. If I had checked Apply to Connected Pixels Only, it would get filled partially. So having this unchecked helps with filling all of the letters which have the same color. Selected layer. To make this feature work, don't forget to select Layer Selected and check Apply to Connected Pixels Only. Again, select your flats layer first where you want the fill to be. While holding the Command or Control button, go ahead and check the layers you want it to refer to. I've selected my floating elements here for demonstration. Layer and folder. For this feature to work, don't forget to switch mode to layer and folder. Try to keep in mind that the flats layer should be inside the referred group folder. Now, if I separate this line art layer from the group, fill tool won't refer to it anymore. Only the layers inside a particular folder will be referred to. Anything outside the group folder will not be taken into account. close gap plus fill narrow areas. Let's discuss what the close gap feature is. If I try to fill this part of the line art here, the fill tool will bleed. But if I try to check the close gap box, you can see that I have initially set it up to 2 bars. If I try filling it again, it would still bleed. If I bump this up to 5 bars, you can see that it was enough for it to be filled. This setting can be maxed up to 50. You can see that the tip here below didn't receive much of a fill. What I do to solve that is to go to Window Menu and then hover to Subtool Detail, then unhide Fill Narrow Areas and click on the checkbox. Then I'll reduce the tolerance to about 0.7 to decrease the margin of the fill tool. As you can see, it fills up the narrow tip of the line art effectively. Tolerance, also known as color margin. I'll switch to refer to all layers mode and delve into the tolerance property. To demonstrate, I'll use my bell tower to show how this property works. This is used to specify how much of the neighboring color should be filled according to the point source clicked. The key is that the result will depend on which point source I click from, as well as on the tolerance amount. For example, my mission is to fill this lit area with a tolerance of 5. Clip Studio Paint will search for pixels that can be considered as similar colors, but only going this far since our tolerance is only set to 5. If I increase it to 10, the color will spread even more since the color tolerance will think that I wanted to consider more of the similar colors based on the exact color point source I clicked from earlier. You can see that this area of the building's roof has much more similar colors because it is in shadow. If I make this darker color as my newly clicked point source and then bump it up to 20, the tolerance property will fill most of the roof's area in shadow. Similarly, if I reduce the tolerance to 15 and click on this new point source, a lot of area will be covered since this part is almost in complete shadow with less color variation. Note that if your tolerance is too high, an amount of 70 for example, the color fill will bleed over since there will be more consideration that the neighboring pixels are all the same color. You can also use tolerance in other ways. Let's say I want to introduce some detail into my flats. I'll set up my line art group to reference here. This is a quick way to lay in different colored patterns. Always note that the higher the tolerance, Clip Studio Paint will think colors are the same. The lower the tolerance, it will think that colors are different. Area scaling. This is used to control the amount of bleeding of fill colors in the line work to a certain extent. You can access various area scaling settings with the plus button here. The rectangle and round setting will result in a fill that is shaped according to its name. I always try to do this with the darkest pixel setting selected though. That way, the fill won't bleed over the line art too much. Area scaling will also depend on the size of your artwork. Again, it's really a matter of tweaking until you get the result that you want. Area scaling result also depends on the thickness of the line quality. If I lessen the opacity of these lines, you'll see how much the fill tool bled into the line work. If you use the rectangle or round scaling setting, if the area scaling is high, it will bleed outside the line art. Enclose and fill plus paint unfilled areas. Introduction to exclude options. If I want to do quick silhouette fills, I will use the enclose and fill tool or paint unfilled areas. It's easier to do this only with line art layers and no other layers around. However, I do have a bell tower layer and text layer visible. And when I use the enclose and fill tool, in target color set to treat semi-transparent as transparent, it does not yield desirable results. To solve this, in target color, select area surrounded by black. I have made my semi-transparent line work into opaque black by duplicating and then merging it multiple times. I will then set the black line art to reference. so that the subtool will fill in a shape conforming to the line art later. In order for the fill tool not to recognize the bell tower layer, I will set it as a draft layer, or simply right-click on the layer thumbnail itself, and then go to Layer Settings, set as Draft Layer. I'll go back to Refer Multiple, and hit the plus button to show other exclude options, like Draft, Text, Editing Layer, Paper Layer, and Locked Layers. For the purposes of this tutorial, I will only exclude the Text Layer and Draft Layer. Once I enclose and fill, the text and bell tower are excluded from being filled. Another trick in color shading is if you set the target color to target all colors. Then create a layer on top of the silhouette fill, draw your shadow guideline, and then you can enclose and fill designed shadow shapes to get an easy read on the artwork. The same exact process can be done with paint unfilled areas. However, the line art should be opaque and no gaps in order for this to work. Anti-aliasing. Here we have two line drawings. The drawing on the left is filled with anti-aliasing on, and the drawing on the right is filled with anti-aliasing off. Notice that the shape filled with anti-aliasing has blurry or semi-transparent edges, while the latter has crisp edges. It's recommended that the anti-aliasing remains unchecked for the tolerance tool to identify colors better and to have cleaner fills. For example, if I reduce my area scaling to -1, filling this purple shape with crisp edges on the right with anti-aliasing on, the fill will result in semi-transparent red and purple hues in the extremities of the purple shape, even though it has 100% hard opaque edges. Closing. Thank you for watching this tutorial on learning how to use the fill tool in Clip Studio Paint. If you have any questions or art topics you'd like me to cover next, comment them below and I'll get back to you soon.